face, right?
Right.
Okay. And there is arrow.
Yeah.
You see that?
Yeah.
In center, the arrow.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Arrow only shows the direction of this stroke. Just follow the arrow. Okay. Follow the direction of this arrow.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And but do not just mimic this very thin, narrow arrow. Try to use one stroke. Do not repeat to fill out all the space of this stroke.
Do it all in one.
Yeah, right. And if not perfectly filled in, it's okay. Never repeat. Okay. Watch my demo first. And, watch dry, and also you can do some.
Do it over again.
Yeah. Okay. First, use tip to touch, and then press, and twist a little bit, and then lift and twist.
Okay.
That's the arrow shows direction, right?
Yeah.
And the light, the lifting and the pressing, look at my, and from your practicing, you will learn more and more. Okay. Touch it. That's why here, very tip here. Touch it. And meanwhile, go, and press harder. Can you tell?
Yeah.
And lifting, and twist a little bit, and lifting.
Okay.
That's why. Yeah.
There's a lot to one dot.
That's the first stroke. Yeah. That's why. And also later you will know this how important. Yeah. Okay. Look at my just in the air. I mean. Touch it and press harder, and then twist a little bit, and eventually, not just a sweep, it's like lifting in the air.
Okay.
Okay. Too much. yes. Okay. First, you sit. More straight in center. Otherwise, only arm, not that's why shaking.
Okay.
Not very stable. And you sit here and let even the power from the bottom of your foot, feet,
okay.
And then you feel more stable. Otherwise, only your arm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And also a little bit down.
The whole thing?
The whole thing, yeah. And go slower.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, probably you thought it's too slow.
I did feel like I was slow.
I know. Actually, every of my students, I will tell them slower.
Okay.
Slower. Much slower than new beginner thoughts.
Okay.
Much slower.
Okay.
The Chinese people do that. Uh-huh. Watch me again. First, you get the right way to touch it, and then slower, do that. And okay, when you lift it, how do I say? Not just like a draw or paint this curve. You do exactly lifting, but meanwhile twist a little bit.
Okay.
Do not just make the curve.
Okay. So your fingers are twisting.
Yeah. Twist and then lift in same time.
Okay.
Uh-huh. And eventually lift in the air. Not all the way, just make, just draw the curve.
It comes out.
Right, yeah. It's diff- slowly, when much slower, when you go at the end.
Okay.
And end, yeah. Well, watch me again. It's dry already.
I know, that's mm-hmm. good.
Okay, touch. And then press and twist. Twist and lift. That's the end.
Okay.
Much better.
A little big, but
much better. One thing I think is the too much water. That's why I said too much. I can tell.
And that's one of my problems too. I don't know proper brush loading. So
right.
This will help.
Right.
Okay.
And also, especially on the paper, it's smeared.
Yeah.
So you have to. You can
have
to very quick.
Maybe that's why I go faster because I have too much.
Exactly. I noticed that. Yeah. Do not just the tip. Sorry.
The whole
thing. Yeah. Especially the some fatty stroke you want.
Yeah,
like some watery lotus leaf or something.
Yeah, then you want
right,
that.
Right. Otherwise, you do not. That's become the excuse of too much water. I have to go back.
Yeah.
Okay. And but I noticed at the very end, you totally you changed
it.
You got
okay.
you got totally
okay.
lost. Yeah. Okay. We'll try again on the other side without this space.
Okay.
Yes, and when you twist the brush, try to do your best. Do not slant it and make this exactly twist.
Still
just
keep it up.
Yeah, keep it straight. Yeah, try to do it again.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Try to do your brush this way. Uh-huh. Otherwise, you cannot.
Am
twist.
I still slanting?
Yeah.
Really?
You cannot twist.
Okay.
Yeah. Try to get used to this way.
Yeah.
Actually, in painting, not that strict.
you can slant.
Yeah, but try to feel out. Do this way. So when do the painting, when you need to some stroke, you need to twist a little bit. You know,
know
why
how.
You
yeah.
yeah you know how
yeah.
uh-huh. Okay, and for this dot, you can do same principle but different direction.
Oh okay.
Uh-huh. See, for example, this we do like this direction, right?
Yeah.
Also, you can do opposite. Look at me. I can do touch this side. Do this.
Right.
Uh-huh. Okay. So touch the tip and gradually press. And I do lifting, twist this way. You know.
Okay.
Try.
Okay.
Try. Cause just the exercise or yeah. Yeah. I understand. I think first is still
too much water.
Still too much water.
Mm-hmm. Am I dipping
almost
too far?
No. When you when you tap it, because it's still too much when you touch the paper, because only avoiding dripping. I mean. Your water. So when you touch that, you can touch that with a little bit harder, and then you go. Yeah, good. good. This one better.
But say I have this stretch.
Right. So practice make make a difference.
Yeah.
And so like this starting, it's like too kind of too weak.
Too weak.
So people can tell. From the things on the paper, right? This with a little bit like a hesitating. Yeah. So this more comfort.
Okay.
Right. But anyway, let you understand more things about the Chinese brush, right?
Yeah.
By pressing and the leveling, right? And also the different twist.
The
brush twisting, yeah, brush twisting, and so this is the first stroke. Mm-hmm. Let's try the second stroke. We try this one.
Oh, that's second.
Horizontal one. Horizontal one.
Okay.
Anyway, you can do everything, but we choose some since we are learning basically for painting,
right.
And you know, we do not learning the exact character.
I want to eventually.
You want to? We'll learn some very good one later.
Okay.
Yeah, first stroke. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is the second we want to practice today, the horizontal one.
Okay.
Tell me the arrow. What's the arrow shows?
Well, it's going this way, then press and lift. I'm not sure why it starts.
Yeah. The stars, okay, look at the shorter one, is that a clear same thing? Okay.
So you press and twist and then turn?
Yeah, kind of, but not, but only for twist brush, not just the draw from the arrow. Arrow only shows the
direction
but just do not just mimic or follow that.
Yeah,
well, look pretty. Right. The arrow shows first, like, in the Chinese painting, lots of strokes, lots of lines, also calligraphy. If this stroke from towards right, towards that direction, first we touch like to this direction.
Okay.
Have you learned that?
Well, I watched your video, the one lesson, and I know you were doing that, but I couldn't. So
not very clear for the principle, just like that.
Well,
you follow that, right?
I understand it, but I don't think I'm doing it right.
Oh, it's very it's the role. It's the very certain role.
Okay.
When you go this direction,
you
kind of
the other
way. Kind of.
Yeah.
We call like same thing as the end. You back, right?
Well,
a
it's
little
like
bit.
Tucking it in. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, you watch very seriously.
I did.
Some people just help you to understand or to remember. Some people call it that's the other kind of the Asian culture thing. Yes. Not very sharp, the throat.
Keep it clean.
Yeah, keep it,
tuck it in,
kind of hidden.
Yeah,
you know.
It makes a difference though on the stroke.
Yes, anyway, I think that's the role.
Okay.
It looks different from just, so do not just stamp. Do not just direct stamp.
Okay.
Look at this one. How to do the follow? Just follow the arrow. So we know we are going to that way, right?
Yes.
Right. The stroke. But first, like touch first, and go a little bit opposite this way, and press until I get ready, and then I walk. Can do it. A little bit faster, and I need to stop, and twist, and a little bit back. Meanwhile, lifting.
So you're stopping like you did the dot.
Yes.
Okay.
And also, the stroke of the whole thing, like make a dot thing, not directly, right? From the very first. So that's the horizontal stroke. How to make the horizontal stroke. So first, touch and go opposite, press like a make a dot, and then kind of adjust the brush direction. Get ready, do not inquire. And then go. And then press, and lifting a little back, you know, take.
Okay. So the hard part's not to hurry.
Right. Your ending is better than the starting. I can tell the whole feeling, full feeling of that. For the beginning, for the beginning part, how do I can tell? I said when you get ready, okay. First, touch it, and you know, your brush, since you go this way, right? Try to tuck in. So you brush it back this way, not ready yet to go that way,
right?
So on the paper, you twist the back brush a little bit, and then see, I'm getting ready to go that way. And then you go.
I wasn't ready to go.
So, I can tell at the very end, you totally got how to stop and lift it for that.
So I have one side.
But when the first one, you want to get the ready of your feeling, and also the trace, the things on the paper, you want to keep it clean and good.
Stay in the line.
So right. So lots of practice. Okay. Go this side first. Like make a dot and twist the brush a little bit. You watch the things on the paper. Also, you pay attention to your feeling to feel ready. And
okay.
Then go, yeah. So both, okay. Not just watch the paper. Okay, I will say better.
It's okay.
On the paper, seems no problem, but I can tell, I watched the process, I can tell you are much more, watch the things on the paper to pay attention to that, avoiding some bleeding or avoiding things, pay more attention to the feeling, to capture what time is good time to
go.
Get in. Well, the power of your, tell me.
It looked like the brush was more twisted than I wanted.
Right.
So
that's why. Okay, look at me. Yeah, keep it drier, less water. You will have plenty of time, not in hurry to. First, go this way. I on purpose need to get this strong start, and you know, twist that. Yeah, more twist. Doesn't matter.
Okay.
Doesn't matter. And you can.
You can just twist it.
Mm, twist it. You still can. You can twist the brush on the paper.
Okay.
And you watch the power of pressing or lifting. You can adjust the very subtle, wider or narrow, right?
Yes,
on the,
yes.
Yeah, yeah. So do not worry. You know, just understand this.
Your ending's getting better. It's very good. It's still getting better and better.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Totally, yeah. But at first, still, I think your brush, the holding brush.
Do I have too much?
The holding brush need more need more control of your brush, and you feel more power on the tip of the brush.
Mm-hmm. Maybe I'm just
right. So certain thing in your mind already, right? Go this first, and
right.
Then ready.
Then go.
Go. Yeah. And kind of repeat this, and then adjust the wide and the narrow, right?
Right.
Make it prettier, and then go.
I'm trying to make it pretty. Part of it too is I can't see when it gets in front of me.
Oh.
And then go straight. Mm-hmm. So when
that's better than the beginning is because you know the brush or you know this loading. Better.
That's true. Yes.
You know how to control it, how fast, you know.
True.
But first, got kind of nervous. And, I said, do not get nervous.
When first
touch it. Okay, in your mind, you know the about the power, how to go, this way and that way, right?
So in the beginning, you're lighter. It looks like, and then you press down.
Right. Lighter.
Cause you have like a thin.
Yeah, kind of, and also kind of you get like Chinese paper always like handmade, right?
Yeah.
Handmade paper.
Yeah.
Every piece different, like a painting as well.
Yeah. That's true.
First you know the paper.
You test it out, right?
Yeah, you know the paper, and you do this loading. Nothing's what's the result on the paper?
Yeah.
The first,
and it's different on each one.
Yeah.
This is different. The magic cloth is different, obviously, too.
Yeah. Right. And also for color or for every time when you touch water and the color, same thing.
Right.
So it's very first you can you touch first very slow and lighter, and then you adjust right and you press. And still, see my brush is twisted.
Yeah,
doesn't matter.
Okay.
You repeat this kind of thing, right? You repeat the stroke, right? And then make not too narrow like the dog bone. but not too fast. Yeah, right. About a little bit, lifting a little bit, about a little bit narrow than it, right? And then you go. Very good. Yeah, and gets much better.
Okay.
Gets much better, and I will say you still need to remember one process is to pause.
Pause
and press.
Okay.
And then ready to go. Not just watch the paper. Oh, pretty good. This is already ready to go. No, exactly to your feeling. You need to. Pause and make sure you can walk and then walk.
Okay.
You need to pause, seriously.
Okay.
have 7 watchers on Facebook.
Trying to make me nervous.
No.
I'm just not getting that beginning.
Oh.
The look of it.
Okay. Look at the arrow of this.
On this
the
one?
Arrow direction of this.
Yeah.
Because it's not very clear. So, not this way, but this way. A little bit, let's see, a little bit up.
Okay.
Right, not, yeah,
I'm going
versus
straight
down, right.
Back.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
A little bit, let's see, look at me. Just look at arrow like that, right?
Yeah.
So try, do not do that.
No.
But your direction goes a little bit back.
So up and then.
Yeah,
down.
And do not over that. See, I'm doing that more a little bit over. I want to show you. Uh-huh.
Oh, you did more than you.
Yeah,
okay.
More than you.
So,
press. Pause. When you're ready, lifting and go. Yeah, that's the way.
Okay.
Yeah. Even a little bit over.
A little too much,
yeah,
then I can bring it back.
Right. Exactly like that. I think you got it.
Okay.
Yeah, very good. Okay, let's move on to other songs. We got tired of that.
Next one.
Yeah, but I think we know more about the brush.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right, to
yeah.
handle it, to control it,
to
make difference.
Right.
Uh-huh. And then, let's try the vertical one.
Okay.
The vertical one. Vertical one at very, look at this one.
Yeah.
Very first, we try to make like kind of the head one.
Okay.
The not directly
straight.
Not just a stamp.
Right.
Not just
right.
a stamp it. It's a front tip, but you still need to like make this thing twist and press. Adjust when you're ready to go this direction and then walk.
Okay.
Down.
Mm-hmm.
See it. Go this drive. Touch it. And then press. Adjust to the direction. Okay, ready. And then go. Even the tip, do not sweeping. By lifting, make it narrow, eventually stop it in the air.
Okay.
Press. Good. Actually, good. I think the weight is good.
Okay.
The feeling is good. But even the not perfect the preacher here, you can buy more practicing to control the fat or narrow
right.
here on for the trace on the preacher. But the weight is
the
correct.
Okay.
Yeah, the movement is correct.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Then try do it again. Yeah. Like the kind of the dot, not in the very center top, like a nail.
Right.
Uh-huh. Look at it, this one. So the dot, a little bit directionally. You press, look at me.
More over to the
right.
Okay.
So not just like when you pause,
right.
Get ready. Like to gather the power and then go, right?
Okay.
But when you pause the direction, I mean for the presence, not just this way, right? And then do that,
right?
A little bit this way, can you tell?
I can,
yeah. So, that's the yeah. And the back to the center, back to the center a little bit, and then go, then go. Yeah. That's the way. Yeah.
Oh, so I still want to go back to the center, but I have to finish.
Yeah.
Okay.
But you've got two left, two left. Yeah, and try you just need more practice to control. I mean, this side a little bit too narrow, right? When you're lifting, it's too faster. You know, just that.
Slow down.
Look at this.
Right.
You back to the center, but still naturally for the brush, still lean to this a little bit, right?
Okay.
Yeah, try one more.
This one?
Mm-hmm. That's the way. That's the way. Yeah. Still a little bit too center. Yeah. But the movement is correct.
Okay.
Correct. But you understand, you know, how to do, we can make difference.
Right. Now I can practice the right way.
Yes. Okay. And did you notice those two we all call vertical.
Right.
The vertical stroke, right? But at the end, they are different, you see?
Yeah.
The arrow shows different as well.
Right.
This directly go this way. But first, I think I showed you, even the very tip stroke shows, but do not sweeping. By lifting to make it gradually narrow, and eventually even stop in the air.
Right.
In the air, shows more power than this one. So in calligraphy, we have lots of strokes at the end, just not sweeping, but not for this.
Okay.
Even very tip.
You still have control and finish.
Yes. Control and the finish.
Okay.
For this one, you do a little bit of back. See the arrow?
Yeah.
Okay. You try to. Okay. I should show you first. It and press it and then lean back and you go down and then lift back a little bit of back and eventually lift here.
Okay.
It's still tip but better than the
single
one. A little bit a little bit bigger, right? Yeah, try. Just play with the brush.
Yeah.
Right. Correct. Very good start. This part, okay. Instead of back from center or from this way, a little bit from this way.
Oh, the other side?
The end, right. The very end. Cannot see, yeah. From this side a little bit.
So go back.
Yeah, a little bit. More straight at the end. Actually.
Oh, so you're looking at the other side.
Mm. This way. Instead of this way.
Okay.
Too fast. Keep at the end too fast. Keep it down at the very end and do.
The beginning okay?
The beginning very good. Keep it straight. Do not thinking of the turning anything right now. Good.
Yeah, I was thinking about turning on. That's why it went that
way. Oh, how come? Then I know why. Right. only try to show different ending part you make this. But when you do the whole stroke, like a horizontal stroke, how straight we there is a description say this. It's like the on the like old house outside the paste shows the rain trace.
Yeah.
You understand? Rain trace on the paste of the old house.
Yeah.
You know, that's very, you know, very straight.
Okay.
Very straight, yeah, because the gravity.
You just bring it straight down.
Right. Very, very, very straight. I need to be very straight. Okay. And then I think try to make this one, which means vertical one first, and then make a hook.
Okay.
And make a hook here. Mm, some strokes of that. Yeah, we have that. The hook thing is very important. Mm-hmm. So especially pay attention, okay, this part, you understand already, you see the same thing as the vertical one, right? Pause first, and then twist your brush, and then stretch out.
Oh, okay.
So do not do the very wrong little curve.
That's what I would have done.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. So it's just strokes.
Now, your beginning was a little different than the arrow.
Actually, I do too slow. I want to show you. And actually, it's the.
So you already did that.
And then go.
Okay.
Or sometimes, actually, when you understand the principle on the paper, sometimes you do not have to do that.
Yeah, once you know
right.
Till then.
Pretty good. Yeah. Actually, with more confidence.
I know.
More confidence.
Yes.
You know, when you get familiar with this feeling,
yeah.
Naturally, you know,
it'll
come for the muscle.
Better,
yeah. The more confidence. Because it's slower, what's the correct.
Right.
A little bit tested. Okay, more pause and stretch out.
Oh.
Lift, stretch out this
lift
way. Not do this, like a rainbow, very rounded stroke. Not do that.
Okay.
Do not do that. By, press and twist the brush and then lift it
out.
Yeah, do that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes. So press more and then stretch out.
Okay.
Stretch out. Yeah. Not just the same power to draw. By pressing and lifting.
So this point is good. That's
yes.
That's the way you want it to look.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And we want to say like lots of this kind of we call kick stroke.
Okay.
Like this dot first and then press and then very quick lifting.
Okay. So I've seen those, so that's that technique.
Yes.
That makes sense.
Alright. Yeah. That's also the stroke by the way we practice here.
Yeah, the same one.
That's the
thing done.
when you do painting, when you do like the throat on the rose branch.
Yeah,
you know
the same type of stroke.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Even the very small brush, but same stroke.
Right, makes sense.
Press down, quick
and
kick.
Out. Yeah, then you get the whole where
yeah.
It's attached
yeah.
And the
yeah,
whole.
Yeah, but not just do the arrow thing. Not just this, right? That's
right.
That's not the Chinese painting. Yeah, by press and quickly.
Too much.
Yeah, quickly. Okay.
Not any more work.
press when you get ready. Concentrate on your feeling. When you get ready and you when you get the power and get the power, and
then you know to go
quick, very quick lifting.
That's not a sharp.
Later you will get familiar with the brush, you know how far you need. Yeah, right.
Okay.
Right.
So
can you do even more more confidence with just a press and a kick? Yeah.
Still fast.
I mean you do this touch and then put more power on of your control of your brush and kick. And then very quickly. Yeah. Press harder. Lift better. Mm-hmm. And when you do this, you do different direction. Like you press.
Twisting.
Yeah.
You do it so fast.
You press this direction and you kick this direction.
Just
yes,
kick
that,
back.
Yeah. Like a perpendicular, yeah. Right.
I just need to go slow.
Yeah.
Until I learn.
Yeah.
So you get
You know when you do one you when you practice it you want to better and better
know
the brush and know the feeling.
Knowing the understanding behind
Right.
Would it be okay to try this one as well? Because that's one that when you go around the curve. I don't understand.
That's the very very hard one, frankly.
Yeah.
Cause for this, you call it curve. Actually, is the folding turning part.
Okay.
In Chinese calligraphy, we are not appreciate lots of the rounded curve.
Oh, okay.
For turning part.
Okay.
Uh-huh. More squarish,
yeah.
Right?
Okay.
Even in the painting.
It's true.
A painting, like I think even you didn't see that properly. You saw the painting of that, like the knee of the Korean.
Right, the crane.
And lots of things, squarish turning.
Right.
Or the tree branch turning part.
Yeah, it's not normally just around.
Naturally not round as well. Someplace, you know.
Right.
Yeah. So anyway, so here, that's what we call it, like the hard turning. Folding turning. Part square, which means squarish,
okay.
Not very soft, rounded.
Okay.
Yeah, just remember
sense.
This. Uh-huh. Okay. Which means technically, we need to finish this stroke and then pause here, turn the other direction by twisting brush, and then go other direction.
Okay.
Need exactly pause. And twist the brush, adjust the direction, and then go.
Okay.
So do not softly.
All in one.
Just draw the
right.
Wrong thing. Uh-huh. Okay. Horizontal first, right?
Right.
Here. Okay, pause, and then make this kind of this direction of the thought kind of, and then adjust the brush, get ready to the vertical one, and then I finish the vertical one, and then pause, get ready, stretch out for the hook.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And you can do the vertical one a little bit bigger than the horizontal one.
So this should be fatter?
A little bit bigger. Because I think people always thinking that the vertical one like the standing, right?
Yeah.
Like the standing one, like a leg are bigger than the arm, you know. Just a little bit, don't too much. Stronger. and then pause when you get ready, and then go. Pretty good.
Is it?
Pretty good.
Okay.
Pretty good. This part is good. The vertigo is good.
This little mess in the middle.
Need more pause and get more ready for the power ready, and then you go down for the vertical one.
Okay.
Do not just draw. See, it's pretty good, and then draw it. When you pause this way and twist, still keep kind of the shape of this part.
Okay.
And
okay.
Uh-huh.
You can put your left hand on the table if you want.
Right, to keep the balance.
Okay.
Yeah, do not just do this.
That is not good. This is way too.
Okay. A little bit over, but I wouldn't call it the movement is correct.
Okay.
This way, after press, when you go, do not lift in too much.
Oh.
Yeah, you make the vertical one, especially at the turning part, too thin. This part, I think your brush, watch me, twist too much.
I felt like I was twisted by the time.
Twist
I got
too much and make this too thin as well.
Okay.
Do this and twist a little bit and do not lift in that much.
Oh, I kept going.
Right.
Okay.
That's why. Look at the wideness. That's why I say that the vertical part actually need to be a little bit wider.
Okay.
I mean, need to be stronger than the horizontal one, actually. Mm-hmm. Okay, better. Too much water, but then you cannot do like a press harder.
Yeah, well, it just smears.
So when I say press harder and also pause longer, you like to put more things to the tip of your fingers to get more power on the brush. Not exactly do the fatter. Stroke.
Okay.
Actually, I think you do too lighter.
Okay.
Look at me. If you do faster, I do a little bit over, but show you the movement. See, I do more like that. More things like that. When the movement, I do.
All right. To get it.
Yeah. Like that. Not whole same thing very even. To just draw, not like that.
Okay.
Yeah. Pause. Great. Yeah, I think the movement is correct.
Okay.
But this is just too late.
Yeah.
So did you get the feeling?
I do.
I have
the concept.
This is very good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. So you got a feeling, huh?
Thank you.
Sometimes I know. Sometimes people say a lot of time. I saw things on the video. And I got confused. I got that thing looks like that. I especially have a problem of that, you know, the turning
hard to hard.
Oh, I know.
But yeah. I was also holding it like this, too.
So you can't do it.
So this is huge to actually be able to practice it.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah. Sometimes, you know, the way you didn't do, you cannot do it.
No,
correctly.
You can't.
Lots of places you need to twist the brush.
Okay.
And only this way you can twist
it. Right.
Okay, twist, use your fingertip and also your feel flexible of your fingers.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Can you feel? Yeah.
I think music helps a little bit. But even keeping it
right. You know where is your fingers.
Exactly.
So, understand. Yeah.
But yeah, I think I was even doing some of this.
Mm-hmm.
So, keeping it round.
But sometimes, I mean, even for me, when I demo, if I concentrate on things or I still cannot avoid, you know.
You do?
Yeah.
It's
but
hard.
First, you need to know the principle behind why we do this, for what purpose, you need to pay attention to that, you know. Okay, for other stroke, I really want to show you is this slant. Did you learn that?
I've only learned what I've watched on your videos. So.
Okay. This kind of stroke is towards the left hand down.
Okay.
Left hand down, and the first it's like a dot.
Yeah.
So every stroke at first, make a dot.
Okay.
Instead of this tip to stamp it, right?
Okay.
It's like the dot, which means pause, and when I get ready, I know the paper and get the direction, and then go.
Now, if this was connected to another, like say a horizontal, would you still do that, or do you start?
Very good question. Connected to others. Normally, this is like for kind of individual or first.
Okay.
Mm-hmm, very first. If there is the horizontal one connected right after that, even for the horizontal one, very good question. Sometimes we do it a little bit apart, but connected, like chi connected.
Okay.
Still do that. And sometimes not that obvious.
Not what?
Not that showy.
Oh, okay.
Not that showy.
Okay.
Right.
It's
you're
a
right.
Little tone
right.
Down.
Right. Okay. And shows they are a whole thing connected.
Right.
Not individual. Just,
you
know
what?
Just
standing
stroke.
Out. Mm-hmm. Okay.
And also sometimes even though we say grass style.
Cursive style.
Oh, okay.
Right? You know, fast the running style.
Yeah.
People do things when you touch paper. Some calligrapher, very famous calligrapher. They do just direct. Yeah, not do everything like that. Right. For the whole thing beautifully.
Right.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, not traditional.
Right. Okay. For this, that's just to practice some. For the controlling brush practice for doing that.
Okay.
First. Okay. Okay. This way. Right. This way a little bit to make a dot, and then gradually lift, narrow down.
And off to the side.
Yeah.
Okay. Keep my hand here.
Good ending. Yeah. Okay. It's very good actually. Try to see if you can you do different length of this if you can, which means you understand what's the meaning of it gradually lifting.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Can you do shorter? Mm-hmm. more, can you do more even?
Not a dot.
Good, good. See, your brush is more controlled, more controlled.
Okay.
Yeah. And now, actually, a very interesting thing. And Harry, can you get the, like a plan, plan for us? Yeah. The very last exercise. I want to show you this stroke. If when we touch it, without this choreography starting, just stamp on that. Press and the lifting, press and the lifting. That's the painting stroke of a bamboo leaf.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh.
I need to get better at that for sure.
Mm-hmm. So that's why. Okay. With no head. Just the print, just gradually press and the just the press, lift, press, lift.
Okay.
Touch it, press, lift. Right? Very good. Very good.
Am I holding it right?
Mm-hmm. Very good. Do you think this is the bamboo leaf? Yes.
Yeah, I think so. I hope
okay.
so.
Okay. Let's do. Can we try like a different direction?
Yeah.
Different direction. Three in a group.
Okay.
Right. When you do like a even like a grape or a grape thing or the bamboo leaf, the leaf thing, always like a cluster.
Right.
Not individual.
Not normally.
So three in a group.
Okay.
But three should be like a different direction, right?
Right.
Okay. For example, like one, two, three. Very good, very good. Okay. Actually, naturally, it's like three in a group, and but on painting, we need to think of they are in the same plant or same group, but do not exactly from the same part,
right?
Otherwise, like the chicken food.
Yeah, chicken feet.
Right, chicken food. And you try to do naturally, like three of them in a group, not exactly same length, right? Uh-huh. Try to do that more natural. And the space in between, a little bit, you know, but thinking of there comes from like a certain inner group, right?
Right.
Inner group.
Same
right.
area.
Right. Okay, but not in the same part, right?
Right. Mm.
And not that even, you know?
No.
Need more, more concentrate to put on the this part.
The beginning.
Right.
Yeah.
So think of, they come from the same, right?
Right.
Yeah, same hidden place, right?
Uh-huh. Right.
I think the composition is really good.
Yeah.
Really?
Okay. Right. The different...
the ending, then you need to
right.
lift more.
It's good. Naturally.
But they're sharp, though. Bamboo leaves are sharp on the end.
You don't have to...
Right.
No? Okay.
Right.
Yeah,
right. Exactly. See?
It could be dull.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And from... We can tell, you know, from... It's just from ink, from naturally, like the material, a little bit of smell.
That's true.
Yeah, but the chi shows lots of power there.
Oh,
not, yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
You could have more muscle and bone instead of the nail, you know, kind of.
That's true.
Yeah.
Right,
okay.
Right. Not exactly, I mean, from the outside, look at, oh, it's very sharp. Yeah, power shows.
It's more hidden power.
Okay.
Right, right.
Yeah.
If the movement is correct, it shows.
That's good to know, because
right.
I focus so hard trying to
right.
get my bamboo leaves right, and I get so frustrated
mm-hmm.
that I focus too much
mm-hmm.
and then they're stiff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right,
so,
right.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah.
I don't have the
so
energy. Right.
Right. After years of practicing, you know what's the you see things even looks not big mistake, but the result looks
isn't
yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, the good thing you know that
I can
and
feel it.
Right. Then you know we find out what's the way. So
okay.
if the movement's correct,
it shows.
Mm-hmm. So do not concentrate too much about the, you know, the very detailed, very sharp,
yeah.
the movement, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the Chinese painting,
okay.
One more chapter of that. Uh-huh. Can you do a like up for the stroke for the three in the group? Mm-hmm. Same way, huh? Yeah.
Yeah,
same way. Yeah,
I do get a lot like this too, where I feel like one side is flat and one is rounded.
That's totally correct.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Oh, it's actually right.
Yeah,
I'm
we
trying
need
to
some this kind of a natural
the
things.
Turning.
Right, and it
okay.
looks not stiff.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Other things like when I try to turn it to the side.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't know if. Then
yes.
I did the mustard seed garden, but I don't remember
yeah.
all of the.
Yeah. And sometimes, yeah, we try to on purposely do some like a narrower stroke,
right?
By the narrower, yeah, to make the side view of the lip.
Right.
Yeah.
So this
yeah.
is good. That's
good.
Okay.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah. And some the things like you said, beautiful.
Okay.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
I'm
mm-hmm.
trying to fix things that don't.
Right. Work. And later on in the real painting. You try to do things like do not afraid of overlap.
And I do because I need to overlap and then it starts to smear and I'm like, oh, that's a mess.
Yeah, this
okay.
is what she did too.
Oh, yeah, I need the spray going.
Great. It's great. Yeah, it's great.
Thank you.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Now, this is just acrylic and fabric medium.
Acrylic,
right.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Very good.
Thank you.
Yeah, very good.
And that
and
was from your panda class, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And later, when you do more advanced, you try to make some, like, the balancing about the space
yes.
and the density part, right?
Yeah.
To make the... more prettier.
Right. I tend to put too much in and then I look back like, oh, there's no breathing room. So.
I understand, yeah. And that's why we learn, you know, we learn better and better. First, we try to control the smearing.
Yes.
And then we try to put every stroke at the correct place.
Right.
And then later, we want to look at the whole picture to learn things or to learn more things about the composition.
Right.
The
and
composition.
The
yeah, from the technique. Some techniques on the composition, of course.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Where to start, right? Where to occupy it.
Yeah.
And which part we need to overlap it. And which part you cannot do, like the knot there.
Right.
And
it doesn't feel right. Something feels off.
Right. And some space, you do not exactly. You want to keep the space.
The breathing room.
Go. Yes. You do not want to arrange evenly to fill up
right.
everything. Uh huh. Some things, yeah, to long time
it,
learning, yeah.
For sure,
yeah.
It takes
yeah.
practice.
Right.
Trial and error.
Right. And like the stroke we just did, some smeary, like the bamboo leaf, not very sharp tip.
Yes.
That shows the power of the movement.
So it's better than having a stiff one with
yes,
the tip.
Yes,
right.
yes,
okay.
yes. And it's not prints, right?
That's true.
Yes, it's art, right?
Right. We're allowed to make little changes.
Yes. And also, for the overlap we talked about, you said you are afraid of the
smeary.
Yeah. But some smeary is okay.
Okay.
Like when you draw the, I don't know if you have experience for the landscaping or for the lotus leaves, you know?
Yeah, that's good then.
Right. And you put the first layer of the lotus leaves or first, and they try to do wing, right?
Right, and they start to bleed out if you do it too soon, but if you wait too long and it's stiff.
Yes, that's why we just, you know, to learn lots of things, basically, to get the right time, you know, and we learned to dry, to stiff, right?
There's so much
to smearing like nothing eventually.
Yeah, you get a big blob.
Totally together. And sometimes, you know, just different paper, they say when you touch it, you know, some people say that the Chinese paper handmade is just frustrating with that. And some people, they advanced in students, you just make a friends with it, right?
With the paper?
Yeah, with the paper. And the very first, you know the first, how fast,
Well, I got the single trunk and it bleeds so quickly, but I like to practice on that because if I can control on that, I feel like I could move the paper.
And once I try to avoid the smearing, try to get things easier, I use the absolute sized paper and to draw the Xie Yi painting of the lotus, and the results turn out
totally
not like the Chinese painting. And I realized that I didn't like it, and I changed back anyway.
No, I know what you mean. I've been trying.
Lots of fun. To play with it.
I've done that with the mulberry paper. Like I did a painting on the single shuan, and then the same thing on mulberry, and it's flat on the mulberry.
Right.
Yeah.
And so, sometimes you like this kind of results. Right?
It depends what you want.
And you learn by doing, right? And then you learn
by
more and more. Right. And sometimes you call this mistake, and sometimes you say, oh, if I do over, it's a mistake as well.
True.
Learn by doing. So do not, totally just absolute afraid of smearing. Some smearing we are expecting.
Okay.
Right?
Let it go. So when you do a painting sometimes, do you do more than one and then pick your favorite?
Yeah.
Do you do it over and over,
right,
trying to make...
It's like practicing music.
But none of them are ever perfect.
Perfect perfection in Chinese brush painting. It's so the nature of this art is accidental. Natural means accidental. There's no, if it's the same or you can repeat, it will be mechanical. It's very dynamic. So you you have to keep trying. It's a just like a gamble, a game of chance.
That's true.
It's a numbers game. So if you practice. If you make 100 attempts for a master, they might have 10% of them are good. Yeah.
Okay.
But for a student, they might have 1%. But your chance will increase. The more you try, the better chance you will have. So even for a master, there's still a chance of fail.
Yeah.
And it's bound to fail to some degree. So you just have to give up. The ironically, if you give up that expectation, you have better chance.
It's true. It seems like it's always my first one because that's when I'm just gonna try this, so I feel calm.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I try it, I'm like, oh, I can try it again, but maybe fix this. And now I want to repeat what I did, and that's when I make more mistakes, and it becomes more rigid.
Mm-hmm.
So just to be calm about it, and it's okay if I make
mistakes. Yes.
But remember, you cannot jump to the number 100 before you do 99. So you have to. So every attempt counts. You kind of accumulate that energy or that through your practice.
Right.
And it's like opera or playing music instrument. It's we call it kung fu. Kung fu means a skill need to be trained.
Okay.
Right, through practice. So it takes time. Yeah. You have to repeat many times. That's why we do this drill first. And do you want a short break? Or we prepare for the ink
practice? Sure. Yeah. If I may, to use your restroom?
Yeah.
Sure. Okay.
Okay, thanks for watching. We'll come back later.